Notebooks, as we can see here. Also das nächste Video jetzt in der Serie über füllhalterfreundliches Papier, die Notizbücher von Paper Blanks. Ahora los libros de Paper Blanks, como funcionan con una pluma fuente. Hier kommen die Bücher zum Beispiel aus der Gutenberg-Serie und die Bücher aus der Book of Kells-Serie, die The Book of Kells Series and the Gutenberg Series. In dieser Serie die Kopien einiger alter Einbände. In this series, the copies of old books. Weitere Kopien von alten Bucheinbänden, diesmal im kleineren Format. Mass copies of old book covers. Okay, stay tuned. I will test these Paper Blanks notebooks with different fountain pens. Also, diese Notizbücher werde ich einer kleinen Prüfung mit verschiedenen Füllfederhaltern unterziehen. Now let's take a closer look at these pen blank notebooks. Here you can see the three most popular sizes, the extra large, the normal size. This is more or less like most of the notebooks, and the small size. This series we got here is actually a recreation of old covers. For example, here we've got a, can we focus it? This is a cover from the 16th, a recreation of a cover from the 16th century. This is a recreation of a cover from the 19th century. Let's take a look here. This is a cover more or less from the year 1800. This is a Renaissance from the 16th century, a Renaissance cover. Another nice cover. Let's see from which time this dates. This is from the Renaissance too. Okay, these are recreations. Here we get another one, a recreation of an old cover. As you can see. And they even got some modern style covers. Okay, this is the series which recreates more or less, with the exception of the modern cover, recreates old style binding. And we got another series. This one is in the style of the Gutenberg Bible. In this case, this closes magnetically. You can see this old style binding, and they even got some Coptic binding, as you can see here. This is the Book of Kells cover. This is probably most famous part of the page of the Book of Kells, the Hero page. Here you can see this X, which is the He and R. You get here, and another, this one we got already here. This is the same, another interesting page from the Book of Kells. So these books come in different bindings, as you can see. The nice part of the Coptic binding is that it can lay absolutely flat. As you can see, they use different papers. We come to this part. You can see this is a more opaque white. This is the white paper. Let's see what. Yes, here they use the white paper too. Another extra of these books is every book gets its small pocket at the end of the book, and they come with this band. These calendars, diaries even come with two bands, and they too have this pocket. And these come with an extra booklet where you can write down telephone numbers. Okay, this is these come in different styles, as you can see. This one has a vertically arrangement, this one too, but for example, here you get all the week, every week on one side and just a few lines on the other side, and this is the third alignment. You can see these are more or less the three different layouts of the calendars. For example, this one is of the year 2015. These are the notebooks. Here we get another notebook. And these are the larger notebooks. As you can see, if you have these aligned, it gives a very nice picture. This is in these books. You can see perfectly made. second to close these books. You've got this rubber band. These are the two different styles. I've got at hand this one with the magnetic style of closing, and all these have their rubber band. Okay, you have seen some really expertly made books, and as you can see here, they use the newer editions use the paper from Italy, from Papriano, which was the first place where they made paper in Europe in the 13th century. Okay, yeah, let's pass these. You can see this is really nice to look at. To make notebooks in this very elaborate style. Okay, in the third part of this series, we are going to take one of my fountain pens, the flex and wet pen, which takes every paper to the extreme. Okay. So stay tuned for the next video. the older paper you had some serious bleeding. You can see this, how it passed through the pages, as you can see here too. This is the older style paper from page 3. Compare that to their newer paper, and you see this is much better for fountain pen writing. Let's see if we have two more. You can see no bleeding through the paper. A few writing examples on paper, blank paper. Compare that to a pre-2008 paper. As you can see here you see the bleeding through the pages, whereas the newer Fabriano paper doesn't have this bleeding through. You can see the feathering too, but they've changed the paper and now you don't have any problems with the This is the old paper, Blinks paper. Now on the new paper. Now on the new paper. With the Uberflex pen.